Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, one time he was sitting with the Sahaba, like in a halaqa, like we always sit. And then there was a man who has his son with him, young son. And he noticed Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that this man loves his son so much, he's hugging him and, you know, playing around with him. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Atuhibbu? Do you love him?" So the man said, "Ya Rasulullah, may Allah love you as much as I love him." So the man went missing for a few days. So Rasulullah ﷺ asked, "Where is he? Where is this man?" They said, "Ya Rasulullah, remember that boy that was with him? He passed away." So Rasulullah ﷺ went to offer him his condolences. And of course, losing a child is something very drastic. So Rasulullah ﷺ told him, would you like to find him at every door of Jannah just waiting for you?" He said, "Yes, Ya Rasulullah." He said, "He is. I did not prepare anything today, but I just got a message that the boy, 8 years old, that we made dua for yesterday, just passed away. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un." 8 years old, Yusuf Ma'roof. I don't know if Ahmed is here, his uncle. He comes every Fajr. Ahmed? Subhanallah. I went to visit him yesterday in Children's Hospital. And subhanallah, they were only letting very few people to go in because it's in the ICU. And the parents, of course, most of us, if not all of us, are parents, and you can imagine how they feel about looking at your own child sitting helpless because of the liver and the kidney failure. He is completely yellow. In such a situation, we have to have a strong, really strong iman. Few things to remember. First, that the one who's testing us is the most merciful. The one who's testing this family is more merciful on them than their own mothers. Second, some people in such a situation, they utter words that are very dangerous. Why? لا يسألوا أما يفعل وهم يسألون. Allah cannot be questioned of what He does. All we know is that Allah لا يظلم مثقال ذرة. Allah never oppresses anybody the size of a mustard seed. وما أنا بظلام للعبيد. Allah never, never commit ظلم at all. And add to that, that Allah is أحكم الحاكمين. He's the all wise. He knows when is the best time for me to leave and when is the best time for my children to leave. And we believe that when a soul is taken, that is the best time for that soul to be taken. One extra second is not good for them. And one less second is not good for them. We all know that Allah Azza wa Jal has wisdom that we cannot understand with this brain that we have, with this intellect that we have. And we also believe, very important, that لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها. There's no way, no way the most merciful, the wadood, the azim, will test someone with something they cannot handle and then they punish them, he punishes them for not handling it. Impossible. We as human beings, I will never see a young child, 5, 6 years old, and I tell him, "Listen, carry this 500-pound box, and if you don't carry it, I'm going to beat you up." As a human being, I cannot do this to another human being. How about the most merciful? So when we are going through the test, we have to know that Allah Azza wa Jal, with that test, He will provide us with patience. We have to remember that. لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها. And another thing we have to remember, that the Habib of Allah Azza wa Jal, this happened to him multiple times. The most beloved to Allah put one child after the other in the grave, and he never complained. If this is done to the Habib of Allah Azza wa Jal, the most beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what do we say? And also we remember that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, with such a loss, he told us that the child will be waiting at the door of Jannah and he will tell Allah, Ya Allah, I will not enter until you bring my parents with me. And one hadith, it says that he will pull them from their clothes, that he will take them with him or with her from their clothes. Subhanallah. So ya akhwan, I have no information about the janazah yet, but go home and hug your children. Wallahi, spend some time with them. Change this attitude that we have of, subhanallah, look at the people who are dreaming to have a child run, and people are dreaming just to have a child, and people are complaining, oh, you make so much noise. Go home and hug your children. And for the children also, the young ones among us, wallahi, make sure you take care of your parents. Because if we are losing young ones, we also buried a brother 46 years old last week. Be kind to them. Honor them. Before a day comes that he would say, Ya Allah, bring them back so I can just smell their feet. So just smell their hug, just to hug them. Bring them back. It will be too late. Now for the smallest thing, we got upset with our parents. For the smallest thing, shaitan come and separate between us. But when something happens, can you imagine if you had a fight or argument with your mother or your father, and you did not, because of your ego, you did not apologize. And then you woke up in the morning and they told you your father passed. How would you feel all your life? Slaughter that ego always. وَخْفِضْ لَهُمَا جَنَاحَ الذُّلِّ مِنَ الرَّحْمَةِ Subhanallah. Yani even every single word, it has to be kareem. It has to be gentle and kind and loving when it comes to the parents. And similarly, ya akhwan, this boy, literally a few months ago, was running around and playing. He used to go to Beam here. And subhanallah, just like any other child, all of a sudden, cancer, hospital, burial. In this situation, what is the dua that we do for the mayyit? As we all know, that there's no maghfirah in this situation, right? You cannot say, Allahumma maghfir lahu. There's nothing to forgive. But the rahmah is always good for everybody. So we could say, Allahumma arhamhum. And there's a specific dua. Allahumma ja'alhu faratan wa dhukhran. Ya Allah, make him a treasure for his parents. Ya Allah, make him يعني go ahead of them to Jannah. وَجَعَلْهُ لَهُمْ شَفِيعًا مُسْتَجَابًا. Ya Allah, make him a person that will intercede, an answered intercessor for his parents. وَثَقِّلْ بِهِ مَوَازِينَهُمَا. And Ya Allah, make him a reason for their scale to be heavy on the day of judgment. So we ask Allah Azza wa Jal to give this family the patience. We ask Allah to give this family the patience. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make him a reason for them to enter Jannah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive all our sins. May Allah protect our children. May Allah protect our children. May Allah make our last deeds, our best deeds, and our last words, La ilaha illallah. Wa sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Subhanak Allahumma bihamdik. Nashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Nastaghfiruka wa natubu alayk.
إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما إن الذين يؤذون الله ورسوله لعنهم الله في الدنيا والآخرة وأعد لهم عذابا مهينا والذين يؤذون المؤمنين والمؤمنات بغير ما اكتسبوا فقد احتملوا بهتانا وإثما مبينا.